Hi, this is Jaya. In this video, we shall see about NTA UGC NET paper 1. We shall see some important points about the new syllabus and the new pattern. We know very well that NTA UGC NET exam is held twice a year and it is very, very important to clear this exam for those who are aspiring to become college professors. So knowing a few facts will help us to face the exam with confidence, and I hope that this video will definitely be helpful to you. Paper 1 is common for all, that is whichever subject we are writing, paper 1 is common, and they are keeping the exam for 7 days. The exam is held for 7 days in 2 shifts, that is 14 shifts totally, and the exam is for 1 hour. Previously, we had 3 papers and it will be for the whole day, but now they are keeping only 2 papers and paper 1 is only for 1 hour. Earlier it was 1 hour 15 minutes, but remember now the paper 1 is only for 1 hour, so we have to be very time conscious while we are answering the paper. And now we have to answer 50 questions. Earlier again we had 60 questions, out of which we have to answer only 50. So 10 questions were left to our choice. But now 50 questions are only asked, and for each question 2 marks is given. So the total marks for paper 1 is 100 marks. And all the 50 questions are compulsory. And how these 50 questions are divided is into 10 units, like teaching aptitude, research methodology, then reading comprehension, logical reasoning, mathematical reasoning, like that. We have 10 units and 5 questions will be asked on each unit. But the best part is there are no negative marks. So it is better, it is advisable for all of us to attempt all the questions. Even if we don't know the answer, it is very good to give a guess answer, because when you omit the answer, you will not get marks. But if your guesswork is correct, you will get marks and that will increase your total and your cutoff will be reached. And many are saying that new topics are added. Yes, it is added, but the previous topics are already there. That is, the syllabus has not changed entirely. Only thing is, new topics are added to the syllabus, and they are added mainly in research, mathematical reasoning and logical reasoning. All the other topics are the same. That is, the same syllabus is there for teaching aptitude and reading comprehension. So the best method to prepare is, we can always take the previous year question papers and prepare. This will help us to face the exam with confidence. Then there are many guidebooks available which come with solution and also tips and strategies how to crack the responses. So that will help you to approach the exam in a better way. And there are many YouTube videos which are produced by those who are handling classes and also those who have cleared the exam. So watching them also will help us a lot. And Wikipedia and Google have lots of information about paper 1 and paper 2 on all subjects. So going through them will be very good. And it is always advisable to take a mock test on ntanet.nic.in, because now it is online, and attempting a mock test in this website will definitely help us to know how we have to handle the exam. And also one mock test will help us to know whether we are able to finish it on time. And the best thing is, on the previous day itself, keep your admit card. The admit card is preferable if it is in color, or even black and white they'll accept, but always take a color xerox, and it must be in A4 sheet. And you have to take a photo. The photo must be in passport size, and it must be the same photo which you have fixed for your examination. And another thing is, don't forget to take an identity proof. This identity proof can be your PAN card or your Aadhaar card or your driving license, but definitely an identity proof is necessary. Main thing is, be very confident. You have already prepared very well, and be confident, and don't allow yourself to become stressed. Therefore, reach 1 hour earlier. That is, if it is shift 1, means it will start at 9:30 and they will close the door at 9 itself. Even if you go at 9:01, they will not allow you inside. So see to it that you reach the venue 1 hour earlier. In case if the place is an unknown place to you, please go on the previous day itself and see exactly where is the place and how to reach it, what is the best means of transport for you, so that on that day you will not panic. And once you enter, all the psychologists will advise you, to take deep breath, because that will help you to relax, and when you are relaxed you are calm, and when you are calm you will definitely do your work very well. And once you log in, read the instructions carefully. This will help you to attend the exam without any panic. And there is always a timer on the screen. This timer will help you to know how much more time is left. Main thing is, don't spend too much time in one question, because all the question carries 2 marks. So attempt as many questions as possible soon. Then later on you can go to the questions which you have not understood or which are lengthy, and you can solve them. Main thing is, don't omit any answers. See that you have answered all the questions. Now your question screen will be like this only, and there you will have all the 50 questions in the keypad. So you will know which are questions you have answered, and you must understand the symbols properly. If the keypad is in white color, it shows that you have not seen the question, that is you have not viewed it. Red means you have viewed the questions but you have not answered it. If it appears in green color, it means that you have answered it and you are very sure that it is the correct answer and you have saved and you have gone to the next. If it is blue with a green dot, you have answered it but you have marked it for review, meaning that you may change the answer later on. Thing is, on online test you have this option. And if it is blue, means you have marked it and you are going to review it and you have gone to the next question. One advantage in this online test is, you will notice below the questions there will be colors, different colors, save and next in green, and then save and mark for review in yellow, and blue will be mark for review and next. Next to the yellow there will be clear response. This is one great advantage in online test, because in case if you feel that you have answered wrongly or if you want to change the answer, you can always go to that particular question, click clear response, your answer will be cleared, and then you can choose the answer which you want, and again you can press save and next. This is one advantage in online test. So after you have answered all the questions, you can press submit. It will go to another page where it will ask you again whether you want to submit or you want to go back to your question answers. You can choose whichever you want. In this way you can easily do the exam. Paper 1 should be completed in 1 hour, so be quick in answering the questions. Don't waste your time. Definitely all the answers will not be very short, some will be lengthy. So you have to calculate your time and you have to answer the paper. I hope this video will be very useful to you. Do well and clear the exam this time. All the best to all of you. Thank you.